We want to make sure that anyone at risk or with osteoporosis is on a good diet with calcium and vitamin D. We know that vitamin D is good even without osteoporosis in the elderly because it prevents falls, which is a huge thing for osteoporosis. So that's a diet component. Then there is a fall prevention component, because if you fall and you have osteoporosis, that's a setup for a fracture. And that could mean a home evaluation, working with family members, working with a patient to make sure that there are no hazards like carpets that patients can trip over and things like that. The next thing that needs to happen is, you know, work on the patient functional status, make sure that the patient is fit, can walk, if they need a cane or another assistive device, that we provide that for them, again, to prevent falls. And then we go into exercise, and there's data to support weightlifting. It doesn't have to be a lot of weight. It can just be like lightweight, but some form of resistance to improve bone health. And then lastly, there are medications. There are several risk factors that are known for osteoporosis: age, female gender, and then there's other things. If you're smoking and you're worried about osteoporosis, or you have osteoporosis, it's very important that you do not smoke. There's a whole number of diseases, for example, rheumatoid arthritis, hemochromatosis, and the list goes on and on and on, that can put people at increased risk of osteoporosis. There are medications, like if you're taking prednisone or other steroids for anything, also increases the risk of osteoporosis. And then genetics also. If your mom or dad had a fracture, that is one of the biggest risk factors for you yourself having a hip fracture.